So today we're gonna talk about these two sick animations. I made these two animations using an open source 3D program. Yeah, you guessed it, Blender. It's the same exact 3D program that I used to make the VFX of my latest videos, such as the CO2 short movie and the Thor VFX. If you haven't watched those videos, I'll leave them in the description down below and also up here. So now let's move into the video. So let's start by the fluid animation of the coffee and the donut. So first of all, you have to model your props. So as you see right here, I model my cup, my plate, and the donut. The donut is from the donut tutorial that is probably one of the most famous tutorials in YouTube for Blender. So I definitely recommend that tutorial. So once you model your props, let's go to the fluid animation. So the next step is to select a domain. So in my case, I made a cube, as you can see, and this is my domain. This is basically what is going to transform into be a liquid. So once you select a domain, you basically make a cube, okay? Make a cube, then go to fluid in the physics tab, go to fluid and select type domain, and domain type into liquid. And that's it. That's how you select a domain. Now let's move to the next step. So the next step is to select the shape that your fluid is gonna take, like the fluid itself. In this case, as you can see here, I select a sphere. So this is gonna be the form of my fluid. So I set this, go to the physics tab and set it to fluid, and the type of fluid, flow, liquid, and flow behavior in flow. So that is flowing, you know? Now let's move to the third step, which is select an effector. So let's jump back into Blender. So as you can see here, my effector is the cup, okay? So you go again, physics tab, fluid type, effector type, collision. Really important that you put the collision, because collision is basically what the fluid is gonna collide. It cannot collide like with air. That's not really possible. Now let's move to the final step. So in this final step, basically what you wanna do is bake everything. So if you go, just jump back into Blender. So if you go to your domain here, okay, you go to your domain, you scroll down, and here, when it says cache, here you're gonna see a button saying bake all. You press that button and it bakes your whole animation. And you just add materials and you have a sick fluid animation like this one. So now let's move to the next animation. So for this animation is this sick cloth animation I posted on my TikTok. I'll leave the link on my TikTok in the description down below. This is the most simple animation, and the reason why I'm doing this video is because a friend of mine asked questions, so I said, so let's do a video to like explain you how I make this animation. Now let's jump into Blender. So as you see here, I have my cubes and I have a plate. That's all you need. That's all you need. So once you've modeled this, that is pretty simple, just a couple of cubes and a plane. So basically you wanna go to plane, to the physics tab, jump into the physics tab, and here you just put cloth. That's it, just put cloth. But before that, really important, and this is the step that I forgot to tell my friend, and it's really important that you guys do it too. So first of all, what you wanna do is jump into your plane and go into edit mode by pressing tab, and subdivided. As you see here, my plane is super subdivided. So basically you can just do right click and subdivide a couple of times. So it's like a grid like this. And once you've done that, you go to the physics tab now, put cloth, and that's it. But there's a problem. So if you just leave it like that, all the cloth basically is gonna like fly and it's not gonna collide with anything. So you have to go to your cubes, you have to select your cubes. Let's say you select all your cubes here, and now you put collision. And once you put collision, now the plane will collide, as you see in my animation, it will collide and form a nice looking and satisfying cloth animation. Now the last thing to do is basically just put some materials on it and some sick music, and you will have an animation like this one. For this video, if you enjoyed, please press the like button and share with your friends. Thanks again to my friend, and thank you for asking those questions. If you have more questions about my work, just put it in the comments and I will try to answer as best as I can. So subscribe so you don't miss any of my videos. See you next time. Bye.